Hey guys, Lillian with Lily Ray's Collection. Today we are going to do a project for Freebie Friday. I'm using the Canson XL watercolor paper cold press. I have some stamps and I have some new watercolor pencils. I usually have my, I work with the Julie Nutting watercolored pencils, but I got these, they were on sale, and so I wanted to try them out, and I was watching Lindsay, the Frugal Crafter. She knows everything there is to know about everything. I love watching her. So let's get the project started. I have my eraser, I have my stamp, Versamark. This is permanent ink, so once you stamp the permanent ink, I should be able to work with my pencils, even though the pencil has water. This is supposed to be permanent, so let me get my, I need my stamp. Lindsay and I go way back to crocheting, crocheting and knitting. Okay, so we're going to do the little girl here. I love her. She's so adorable. Oh, wait, I want to stamp the background first. This is a Christmas stamp. Let me see, like this direction, like this. So I just want to kind of tap it here and there and give it some background. And this is saturated. I want to do one there, one there, up here, and that should be plenty. I use a wipey to clean these up. That's not a wipey. This is my wipey. I like to try to keep them clean. Let's just set that aside. And then these are, this says Color Me Happy. So we want to do some of these paint splatters. Too many. Do this one again. Oh, I don't want to get my head in the way. Okay. All right. Now we're going to put her back. Okay, so let's see where we're going to put her. I should have left the line so that I could put something down there so that she's not floating on air. Maybe just right there. Okay, she looks beautiful. So we don't lose her. She's pretty old too. She's very old. Okay. Now that we've done that, sorry, I wanted to make sure I clean this because I don't want the stain in the back. Alright, we can put that away. I have my gel pen there, and I have my little girl. I wanted to put something behind her, like, let's use one of these guys. I love these guys. I think I'm gonna use him. They're together celebrating Christmas. Right? He doesn't have anything indicating that it's a birthday. So, yeah, let's try and stamp him. Okay, I want to stamp him. Nice. Maybe right there. Perfect. It looks like he's looking at her. And then we can take these are little hearts. Well, I want to give him a little bow tie. Let me make sure this is clean. Okay. So I want his bow tie to be there. Okay. I want to kind of spread some hearts, like there and there, like the heart is coming from him since he's looking at her. And I think that that's it. The hat fell out. Where's my... I gotta be careful. I don't want to lose this one here. Just put a little... Okay, so we could put him over here. This crazy guy. I need a new block. Oh no, wait, I want him to be on the opposite side. So I can't stamp him like this. I need somebody else. I need this guy. Are they all facing? What's going on? Wait. This one's like this. Okay. There we go. So then this guy, I want him to be like in the background. Like he's looking at them, but that's good enough. So now she has her friends with her. Let me close this up and let's get into painting. Okay. This is a new one. Now, my pencil is, watercolor is, pencil is Jane Davenport. But I've used it a lot, so much so that it has the tint on the brush, and I've cleaned it out. So that's what I'm going to use. Now, let's see how we're going, what colors we're going to use. I wanted to use Christmas colors, so I'm going to say he's wearing a tuxedo with a red tie. I haven't done my swatch for this, so let me take out my reds. Back here it tells you these are Arteza pencils, watercolor pencils. And oh, there's the rating. These are the ratings. This is 3, 2, and 2. So 3 would be the best, 2 is intermediate, and then 1 is considered low. Apparently Arteza decided to change the rating system and the direction that it goes. And this one's 3, so this is magenta. I'm gonna have to, let me use this. Maybe I should do this first. Give me a minute and I'll be right back. Okay, so I completed my chart for the Arteza Watercolor Pencils. And so, those are the other ones. Now I can go ahead and color without coloring too hard. And then I'll come back in with my pencil, with my watercolored Jane Davenport. Okay, and then I'm gonna do, I don't know, there's not really a real red. Even the magenta is pink. It's not red. Oh, maybe I could use the garnet. There it is. Okay, we're gonna do the garnet for the shade. And again, don't press too hard. And these watercolored pencils don't have wood inside, so you can't drop them. If you drop them, you ruin the actual lead. So you have to be extremely careful with them. Let's see what this looks like. And you don't want too much water either. So make sure you kind of dab your pen. I think this is spilling too much water, but I can't find my other barrel. I'll let that drawing come back. I also want his tie to be I likey. I'm gonna make his beak is orange. and I'll probably have to do a speed through. His eyes are going to be, I'm going to give him as well as this guy. I'm going to give him yellow eyes. These pencils are a bit strange because they're not round. They're like a diamond shape. Make a mistake, you just put the water brush on it, dab it, and that takes it out. Okay, now we're going to make his jacket. Let's do a periwinkle. Let's do a periwinkle, periwinkle. Here it is. Periwinkle with I think indigo. Indigo. Okay. So I'm gonna make the indigo. I'm gonna make it here, like for his the back feathers. Again, you don't press too hard. So this indigo is going to be like the shading. And then the periwinkle is going to be very light. Body, I think I'm gonna make that caramel. Let me see. Caramels, I think this one doesn't look like a. These colors on the sticks, this is supposed to be caramel and it's kind of green. But it's here and it's not green. I kind of don't like that. see what we're gonna do here. I'm gonna do this one first. I really hope my head is not in the way. I'm gonna do all of my colors first. Do the blue. And now let's do the dark. Bit so that you can see the contrast. Okay, I gotta let that dry. I think I want to go over his jacket a little more to make it darker, but you have to let him dry. And so now, let's use orange for his beak. This one is pumpkin. And then we're going to use Coyote, which is this green, which is okay. That's the darker one. So we're going to put his shading to use, I think, yellow okra. That's lemon. I think this is yellow. No, this is turmeric. Okay. Yellow okra is this one. Okay. I'm going to use the yellow okra here. gonna use, where's the, this is Coyote, moss, I need moss. Forest green is this one. Maybe I could use pear. I'll use pear. I'm definitely going to have to speed through all this because this video is going to be too long. Okay. Now let's see what we have here. Let's do the lighter color first. And the green. And then this dark color. I think I did his beak. Okay, I think that looks really good, but I'm definitely gonna have to speed through this. Okay, so now let's go ahead and do, what color hair should I give her? Let me keep these here because I need these again. We're going to give her a, this one is lilac. Lilac. Eggplant is nice too. Lavender. Okay, I want we'll make the paint. And lavender. She's got a big belly. Then we'll make her collar lilac. And her cuffs lilac. Oh, my stomach is growling. And then we're going to take eggplant. This one's not eggplant. Where is the eggplant? Here it is. And we're going to do a little, I think these are bones. I'm not quite sure. Sneakers. I want to make them eggplants. I really hope my head is not in the way. Then we're gonna go with Noor, if I could find it. Noor, which is black. It's a gray black. Oh, and then I need to make her her belt. Eggplant. And then what else? I want to give her let's use this one. I'm going to give her caramel hair. We're going to do a mix. We're going to give her some highlights. I still have to do her face. How flippity-doo. And also her bun. She has a stick going through her hair. sunflower. Where's the ivory? This is for her skin. And this is for her skin. So ivory. You know what? I'm going to use turmeric. Okay. Let's do, what is that? Is that her mouth? Oh my God. Let me do her clothes. I like doing this on Freebie Fridays because it gives me a chance to practice. You know, when you're paper crafting, you don't get a chance to do your media. And to get better at this, you have to practice. I like using my markers. And they're drying out. Got some big shoes for such a little girl. Now, I'm gonna clean this. Let's do her hair. And this is gonna be a blend. Because I want it to look like it's highlights. Oops. Like it. Now we have to get her skin done. We don't have a lot of options with that. Let me see. This is peach and apricot. I think that's it. And caramel. Maybe even ivory. I don't want to use peach. Ivory is the first one. Where is ivory? It's gonna blend into her hair. Let me see. This one is turmeric. Let's see what it's wet. Can't do this too hard because your paper is gonna peel. You don't want no peeling paper. Okay, this is ivory. That, I'm gonna assume that that is her mouth. I'm gonna do the light first. Especially around here like that. And then this one is peaches and green. I think I'm gonna have to use the jewelry netting. For her face, because there's no real colors for her face. Let me see, that's too dark. What about burnt? Burnt. Sienna brown is too burning. Julie Nutting has better colors for her face, because this is not going to work. It looks okay. Do the yellow under the, gotta do her neck. I'm definitely going to have to tweak this off camera to have it ready for you guys. I mean, I think she looks okay. I just need to, I feel like I need to darken his suit a little bit. I have to definitely give her some pink lips. Should I do pink? Or she needs rouge. She doesn't have rouge. And then her lips. just my hands. Okay. Let's give her some pink lips. Some rouge. Up and see what's going on. I think she looks good. Let me give her some pink laces. These are kind of light, but see if I can stay within those lines. See something here. This is the lavender. A little darker in between here. I should use this one. Yes, I'm still almost done. Need a couple more minutes and I'll be done. skin is done. Okay, now what am I going to do with the background? I need to do something with the background. Over here, let's say that they are on some greenery of some sort. What is this? Mint. This one is pear, lime. Oh, let's do spring green. Do it like this. So I could give them a place to stand on. Let's do couple of different grains. What is this? Pear. Okay, here we go. Okay guys, I think I'm gonna leave it right there, and I'm gonna have to splice this together. I'll be right back.